everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Pumped up for this one. This college football rivalry is going to be full of hard-hitting action.
It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Seniors are throwing on the home jerseys for the final time in their career. And for these kids, an awfully emotional time. You always want to go out in style and get a win. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's brought down in the open field. Around an 8-yard pickup on the slant route from the quarterback. That makes it second. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. On the pitch, look out, loose ball. Has some daylight. He goes down at the 41. The defense was that close to coming up with a big play.
Yeah, they tried to get a little bit too fancy there on that option play.
From the 41-yard line. First down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
Man left.
Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. He chucks it downfield. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
They looked awesome on that play. A well-thrown football and a great effort to get the ball into the end zone.
And he converts the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The Jayhawks and Wildcats in the Sunflower Showdown. Rivalry is the essence of the sport, and cutting the other guy's guts out, figuratively, of course, makes it all the more pleasurable. And for Neil, he made it into the end zone once. The Jayhawks pull it out by a field goal. Elsewhere, the Spartans and the Nittany Lions square off. The prize, the land-grant trophy. This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. Thorns developing nicely as a passer. He threw for more than 100 yards in this one. The Spartans win it 31-24.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And they make the stop at the 25-yard line. It's second and seven. Ball on the 25-yard line. Toss left side. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. Third down.
And he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
From their own 34-yard line, first down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's taken down at about the 45. The offense was pretty successful on that play there.
That was a very good passing play to get the ball downfield for a very nice gain and a first down.
He fires left side.
This is incomplete. Number 84, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second.
From their own 45-yard line. Second down. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Around the 48-yard line. Wow, a long gain, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
Runs outside for a nice gain.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Knocked out immediately after the catch.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From the 31-yard line, it's first down. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Makes it out to about the 23.
That's a deep lead on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it fourth and inches.
And the goal line defense digging in here. They run for the first, and they don't get it. The defense holds, and the ball will change hands.
Well, the offense looked like they wanted to bounce the ball to the outside, but this defense just has too much speed. It did a good job of shutting off the edge and preventing the ball carrier from getting to the first down.
They punched it in for six on the last series. Can they do it again?
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
There was some movement on the line. That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Right around the 22-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
And he's brought down there by the senior at linebacker. That won't be the last time today we'll be talking about this young man.
Notre Dame up 7 points. He's tackled at the 48. First and 10, ball on their own 48.
Mike three.
And he's tackled at the 47.
Inside the 42.
They come out on an empty backfield. Makes the grab and he's got the first. Tackle made at the 31.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31. He makes it to the 28-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Notre Dame is up a score. So his fifth run of the drive goes for another first down.
This offense is running the ball very effectively on this drive.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Fires quickly to the tight end. Touchdown. On the extra point.
Here's an update from the studio and restate.
Time to gig an update from College Station. And for Missouri, they're sleepwalking through this thing. If they don't turn it around, they're going to get into a world of trouble. Texas A&M leads it 17-10.
I don't expect that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. There are three quarters remaining. Notre Dame's in front by 14.
It looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
Here's a run. He fights forward to about the 26.
Gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Second and nine coming up here. Ball on their own 26. And he's stopped behind the line.
Completely stopped immediately.
Callahan is back deep to return the punt. Callahan takes it to 28, gets to about the 37-yard line.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. They'll bring him down at the 45.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Makes it to the 47. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Quickly to the tight end. He's at the 30, and they make the stop at the 25.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
From the 25-yard line, first down. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Man left, man left. Four down. 0-0, Mike three.
Fakes to the back. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Four down. Mike three.
Nice play to set up first and goal.
Call it a gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and goal.
We're at play number nine of this current drive. Bring him down behind the line. Ball inside the 10-yard line. It's second down. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Kicks away, and he's got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Thompson from the one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 29. It's still only the second quarter. We got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Gets out to about the 31. A yard, maybe two on the carry. Stanford's going to use their first time out of the half here. From their own 31-yard line. Second down. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down at about the 39-yard line. Taken down at the 45-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. There's a strike complete. He goes out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
That's good enough for another Stanford. First down.
Mike seven.
Nice run, and he's brought down. And they may need to hurry here.
Well, you'd think so, but there doesn't seem to be much urgency on the field right now.
Just a minute to go in the first half of play. Incomplete, and he let his receiver a little too much.
One of the things you look for when you have a young quarterback is how he releases the football. Here you can see he releases the ball a little bit early, a sign that he wasn't completely comfortable with what he was seeing.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately.
That's a gain of one on the play. That'll make it fourth and six.
Sanborn is the punter.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly. And it gives them a long field to work with.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. He gets out to about the 21-yard line. We've played a half of football. Notre Dame leads it 17-0.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half. And you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of. And it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes. Because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Thompson fields it at the one. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. No Notre Dame's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
They'll run it. He's out to the 30. He gets to about the 34-yard line. From their own 34-yard line. First down.
That's right, baby. They don't want it.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
From the 35-yard line, it's first down. They bring him down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Reset, tight right.
Mike 10. Mike 10, Mike 10.
Down to lose one.
And he's tackled right away. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Zips it to the tight end. Tackle at the 28.
Why in the world would the offense run a route short of the first down? That just baffles me every time I see that.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. It has the distance, and he nails the long field goal. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
Duke and North Carolina square off in the battle for the victory bell. And for North Carolina, let's keep an eye on this game where a major surprise could be brewing. Duke leads it 31-24. In other action, time to check in College Station. Let's take a look at this one again. And for Missouri, all the ingredients look as if they are starting to fall into place for a potential upset. The Aggies have the edge 27-20.
You can never look ahead a week, but that would be a pretty big upset if that score holds. Stanford to kick. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Down at the 26.
That brings us second and nine.
We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 26.
Mike three.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Come out in a five-wide set. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 42.
Williams is at the tackle at the 42-yard line.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42. ends at the 48.
Gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
Outside after a nice pickup. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
That makes it second and six.
Got it on the quick throw. And they push him out at the 24-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Yardage on that run. Potter picks up about 7 yards on the run.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. The 10. Nice run to the left there.
7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
10th play of the drive. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 9-yard line. This is the 12th play of this drive. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. He gets it up, and it is good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Taken down in the backfield.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Out to his wideout. They'll bring him down around the 50-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
From midfield, first down.
Watch the screen. Watch the screen. Watch
try the right side. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
Made at the 49-yard line.
Loss of 2 yards on the play.
That's three down and one to go. Notre Dame's lead is 17. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He fires.
This was incomplete. Higgins was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
So they're going to go for it here. Caught out in the open. And they make the stop right around the 38-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He lets it go, and they couldn't hook up on that one.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. And he's taken down at the 30-yard line.
That'll bring up third and two.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Mike 10. What's the run? They're running it.
They go.
Makes the grab, and he's got the first. He's taken down around the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, first down. Draw play, and the defense was ready for it.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. Nice run there as they work the outside. From the 13-yard line, third down. Big play, and it's first and goal. And this is the 14th play of the drive. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. And down he goes around the 1 yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings him second and goal.
From the 1 yard line, it's second down. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
The Tar Heels were ranked 22nd. Now they'll be lucky to hold on to a spot, any spot, in the bowl. You could almost sense during the week that this team was ripe to be upset. They showed up, not ready to play, and down they go. Duke wins it 38-31. In other games, let's check in on the SEC where the supersonic speed defenses wreak havoc. The Aggies get the victory, 34-27.
Wow, what an upset. I'm not sure anybody would have predicted that one. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He got hit hard. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He's under pressure. He's wrapped up for the sack. From their own 21-yard line, second down.
Mike three.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackles at about the 27-yard line.
That makes it third and three.
To go long and does. And he's hit immediately. He's got 100 yards in the game now.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He fights forward to about the 26. Stanford's going to take their first time out of the half. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Him hard at the 23-yard line.
Brad, I think offensive coordinators spend more time focusing on two areas for an offense, third down conversions and red zone offense. Right now, this offensive coordinator has to be really happy with the way this offense is executing in their third downs. That's the second time they've been able to get a first down in this drive on third down.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
Stanford's called their final timeout. Second down and 10 to go.
Ball in the 23. Makes his way out to about the 15.
That'll bring up third and 2.
This is the 9th play of this drive. Makes it to the 12-yard line.
First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. Brought down at the 4. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 20-10, Notre Dame. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Notre Dame came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.